In February 2006, the James Bond film unit travelled to the Bahamas to begin work on the first action sequence of the new 007 movie, Casino Royale. Daniel Craig will replace Pierce Brosnan in the lead role as a younger, harder Bond at the beginning of his career as a 00 with British intelligence. The stunt sequences in particular will need to reflect the new, grittier Bond, and the action units face a major challenge. One thing's for sure, whatever stunts they decide to do, they'll do them for real.
Stunts are as near to real as they can possibly be, which in this case is very real.
This is a very tough and hard Bond at the beginning of the movie.
I am passionate about my art, and I will fight him tooth and nail to do it for real.
A large part of the action in the Bahamas sees Bond chasing his prey through a construction site.
We've been doing the middle part of the opening sequence, which is basically Bond chasing Bomber through a construction site, all up the girder work, up these cranes, down the inside of the building, and back out again.
Finding a suitable location for the scene was a potential problem, but producer Michael Wilson knew of an abandoned hotel he'd spotted during the filming of the 1977 movie The Spy Who Loved Me. Fortunately, it was still there.
When we're looking for a building under construction, for a film company, it's just about impossible to find, because by the time you go and look at a building, you have to plan to work there, and then by the time you're done planning, the building's moved on and probably finished. But this place, being an abandoned building, it was easy for us to make it look like a construction project that was still going on.
Everything in the Bahamas is imported anyway. They don't have anything really here, so we had to bring all our own equipment. I think we had about 12 40-foot containers. It was just a logistical shipping nightmare as well to get it all here, obviously, for enough time to start building the set, to have it ready for shooting. So we had about a 6 weeks prep to get everything ready by the time the shooting crew turned up.
To make things a little more interesting, the focus of Bond's attention throughout the chase is skilled in the art of free running.
Sebastian, who plays our bad guy in that sequence, is a free runner, and it was my job to try and keep up with him.
Sebastian Fouquin is the co-founder of free running, or parkour, and the producers were quick to cast him as Malacca in the chase.
The free running came in because our writers suggested, we looked at some tapes, we thought it would be an exciting thing to introduce.
The sport came to the attention of the writers when they saw a documentary called Jump London, which featured Sebastian performing his discipline around various London landmarks.
This is parkour, the anarchic new sport of free running. Free running is a new urban sport and was created by Sebastian Fouquin, born out of the childhood games of him and his friends.
Free running's the art of moving from A to B as quickly and as efficiently as possible. If there's an obstacle in your way, it's about being able to go over it or find a way around it.
We try to find something very functional, very efficient, more than to do something like tricks, something like this.
It's an art form, and throwing yourself sort of over impossible gaps and using the urban surrounding as your canvas to throw yourself across buildings, and Sebastian's particularly good at it.
It was important to get a sequence that was unusual and different, and it's a foot chase. It's simply the two guys, one chasing the other. And you have this free runner who's incredibly lithe and powerful. He can run and jump almost like a ballet dancer. against Bond, who has the power and the strength, but doesn't have the finesse.
This scene's all about stunts. It's a very fast-paced action sequence, a lot of breakaway special effects, bits and pieces. So it's just a one continuous journey all the way through. It's really, really fast, free running.
Bond chased me now, like all the time. But now he's with a digger, and the digger will crush the house over there. And me, I have to
fire him like this, bang, bang, turn, bang, and running.
We got a 17, 18 ton digger up to about 35 mile an hour. Great big run up of about 300 yards, and gonna hit the side of that truck there. Got a few pyros in there, a few sparks, and a lot of debris.
All these things, blah, is why I need to run very fast.
This is a stunt, okay? And, you know, God forbid, anything goes wrong, his brakes jam, anything like that, or whatever happens, fails, it can just keep coming. So we don't want anybody in this area here at all. All the unit, keep way back. If you're not involved in the shot, you've got to keep well back.
Digger needs to smash into the hotel construction, narrowly missing Molacca.
There's an existing opening in the concrete slab, which they basically filled in with a steel frame, which is then filled in with breakaway slab. The course has been worked out very carefully. When the digger hits the slab, basically the whole thing crumbles. So that was all worked out by special effects. And the size of the digger, obviously, which is massive in relation to the building. Then it's all finished to look like concrete, and hopefully you don't realise it's not real.
We came up with the idea back in England that it'd be nice to see the bucket hit the concrete, and it basically causes a wave of concrete behind the bomber. So Chris Corbould built a couple of rigs and experimented with them, and he came up with what he came up with. And Martin's whole brief on all this is we want to do it for real, and we want to do it for real as well, because for us it's so much more satisfying. Marvin done a fantastic job of leaving the timing just perfect.
How's that, Marvin?
Oh, the knots.
Enjoyed it?
Yeah, can I say the knots? No, that was nice. That was nice, that one. I like that.
Good. Cheers.
While work continues by day on the construction site, the action team spend their evenings piecing together storyboards for the next stunt sequence, a dramatic chase around Miami Airport.
93 and 94.
It's a huge sequence. Miami Airport, we bring into the equation tugs, petrol tankers, luggage, all of these things combined. I mean, it's terrifying.
Back on set, Martin Campbell is determined to keep on schedule and now has two units shooting the free running sequence.
Action! Martin just wants to crack on and get as much energy into it as possible at the moment. And the energy of it's about making it as exciting to watch as possible.
Having trained 3 months for the role, Daniel Craig is keen to do as much of the action as possible.
Of course, it's an action scene to start with, you know, and he's extremely good at action. He looks very impressive, he moves impressively, and he handles himself well, extremely well. So that was a big relief.
It's dangerous stuff, so we have to be on top of it, but the energy's in the right place and the concentration levels are in the right place.
Gary's boys, Ben, who doubles me, is my fight double. Who's, you know, he's a fighter. I mean, and I've got to try and be at his level. Otherwise, there's no point. He's got to be doing the best he can as much as I've got to be doing the best I can. I think the fights should make you wince a bit. It should look like they hurt.
3, 2, 1, action!
We end up on top of this building site, and we're 200 feet up, I think we are, on a crane. jumping from crane to crane with a fight sequence in between. And it was incredible. I mean, I'm not fantastic with heights. I mean, I don't know many people that are fantastic. But I didn't really have an awful lot of time to think about it. I just had to kind of get up there. Being up very high and being calm and calming yourself down is it's quite a kind of spiritual experience.
You shoot up to the cranes and there's a little bit of a fight up on the top crane, which is the first one there. That'll lead us into then the two jumps, which we're doing today.
We measure out what the actual jumps are and then we do it on ground level. So say like the first one's 18 foot, we do that 18 foot on ground level, getting it right and knowing exactly what D-cell we're using on the equipment. Then we do the second one, do exactly the same again. But Martin's brief was the bomber's one has to be in one. So he literally jumps from the top crane to the middle crane, climbs over, jumps from there to the roof all in one shot. The dangers with that is obviously the wind. We were very lucky on the day that the wind was absolutely perfect for us. We had a limit of 12 mile an hour on the wind, so we couldn't jump if it was more than that, because basically the cranes will not operate above 12 mile an hour. Obviously the stunt guys, when they jump off the top crane and land on the middle, the second crane, their landing area is literally only just over a foot long or a foot wide. So when you're sort of up 140 foot looking down and you're literally looking at like a foot by 2 foot landing platform, it's not sort of fantastic.